The name's Flick. Flash Flick. Since No Time to Die is out in theaters, I thought I'll review all of Daniel Craig's James Bond films, starting off with Casino Royale. Can be considered to be a reboot of the James Bond franchise. I mean, it took the franchise in a very gritty and realistic direction, and absolutely love this film. I think this is a great James Bond film, but other than that, it's also a great film within itself. I mean, you don't need to watch the other James Bond films, you don't need to be a fan of the other James Bond films in order to like Casino Royale. Now, me personally, I'm a huge fan of the entire James Bond franchise. I've watched every single James Bond film ever made, from Sean Connery to Daniel Craig. Absolutely love all of those films, and Casino Royale definitely feels different from the other films, but that is also the reason why it is so great. Before getting into the review, I might touch on slight spoilers, because I mean, this movie came out in 2006. It's a long time back. If you haven't watched Casino Royale, go watch the film, come back and continue the video. That's your warning. Let's get started. Casino Royale opens with this black and white sequence, which is something you don't expect going into a James Bond film, because every single James Bond film prior to this one opened with this huge action sequence that is really grand in scale. But this one, surprisingly enough, opens with a sequence that shows you how James Bond got his 00 status. So essentially, you have to execute two kills in order to get a 00 status, and we see both of those kills being edited simultaneously back and forth. Now, it's an interesting sequence to open with, because one, it shows that this film is going to be completely different from the other James Bond films, just from the fact that it isn't opening with this grand, huge, large-scale action sequence. And also two, it gives an interesting insight to James Bond's character as to how he has become 007. So that I thought was an interesting layer. It opens up and then you get the theme song, and then you have this incredible parkour chase that honestly is one of the best action sequences in the entire James Bond history, according to me. Just look at the way it is edited, look at the way it is shot. It's incredible. I mean, this entire parkour chase, I was absolutely thrilled. It has a few cheesy moments, but they blend it so well with the grittiness that the film is going for. And every single time I'm on the edge of my seat watching this sequence, it's so brilliantly directed. Now, talking about direction, this film is directed by Martin Campbell, who's also directed another Bond film, GoldenEye, which is the introduction to Pierce Brosnan as James Bond. So Martin Campbell definitely has this flair for introducing new Bonds, and he does both of those films so differently. GoldenEye feels more like a 90s film. I mean, that did come out in 1995, so it is essentially a 90s film, but it has all of the campiness, the cheesiness, and of course the over-the-top nature, but it works so well for that film. Absolutely love GoldenEye. I think it's one of the best Bond films, just like Casino Royale. Now, Casino Royale on the other end of spectrum, Martin Campbell does something so different. He tones down on the campiness there and gives us a more realistic and gritty James Bond film, which I love. I love the fact that the exact same director chose two different styles to introduce different Bonds, and I just find that fascinating. So yeah, coming back to Casino Royale, I'm not going to break it down scene by scene. I'm just going to talk about my favorite moments, generally the things that stand out. Let's just talk about Vesper Lynd. Now, Vesper Lynd is probably one of the best Bond girls of all time. Eva Green is a great actress, she really gives a great performance. But more so than that, she really feels like an equal to Bond. There's a conversation between Bond and Vesper on the train, where each of them try to deduce details about the other person. And the way the scene is done, you really see that Vesper is an intelligent and capable woman that really has abilities that mirror that of James Bond. And the entire scene is very well written. And throughout the film, you see how integral she actually is to the plot. The eventual love story between Bond and Vesper is extremely important to whatever happens after that. And her subsequent death to the film is also integral to Bond's character in this film. So you really see that Wesper is a very important character, and I absolutely love the direction Martin Campbell went with, you know, and, you know, sort of giving us a Bond girl that is actually as capable as James Bond himself. And, you know, I have to talk about the action in the film. It's incredible. I've already talked about the opening sequence, which is great. But every other action sequence in this entire film is just directed so well. Take, for example, the stairwell sequence, which is brilliantly shot. And every single action sequence in this movie is just so, so well put together. And the cinematography is really striking. It looks colorful and it just pops. I really love the cinematography in Casino Royale. And the casino sequences, the sequences where you have Bond and Le Chiffre. I have to talk about Le Chiffre. I'll come back to that in a minute. You know, when they're playing poker, it could have been directed in a way that just feels bland, because, I mean, they're literally playing poker. What is so exciting about that? But what works so well in Casino Royale is that even in these poker sequences, there is a level of tension and suspense maintained because of the stakes that the poker game has. If Bond loses, he's indirectly funding terrorism, because Le Chiffre wins and he eventually will use it for terrorist activities. And because of that, the stakes feel always high, and the way it is edited especially, that just maintains the thrill and the suspense throughout these poker sequences. And Le Chiffre, the villain of this movie, you clearly understand the motivation behind him. You clearly understand why he's doing this. You clearly understand his motivations, but at the same time, he's so cold and is so villainous in nature. I just really love the blend and the way Mads Mikkelsen performs and the way he gives his performance. It's actually very cold-blooded, and I absolutely love the villain in this film. He's great. After the poker game ends, we actually see Le Chiffre going out and torturing Bond, which is, I mean, that is painful to watch, honestly. And, you know, that sort of grittiness, that sort of rawness has never been done in a James Bond film before. I mean, did you ever see a James Bond film where, you know, he's so brutally tortured by the villain? I haven't seen one. So, you know, that was a very intense sequence. You know, after that, Le Chiffre dies, and because Mr. White kills him, and then you see Bond and Wesper go out. Bond gives in his resignation, which is quite surprising the first time you watch it. And then there is this sort of a love story vibe to it, a light-hearted feel to it. And one of the best things Martin Campbell does so well is that he changes the tone of the film so seamlessly and so effortlessly. It flows so beautifully, and the pacing is incredible. I mean, this film is 2 hours 20 minutes long, and it never feels that way to me. Every time I rewatch it, every time, it just flows by, and it honestly just feels like a 2-hour film, and that's how brilliant the pacing is. And now later, Bond gets to know that Wesper has double-crossed him, and because of that, we have this really great action sequence in a building that's, you know, collapsing. And then later, he gets to know that Mr. White, you know, he was the one who was behind all of this. He goes to his estate, and then he shoots him in the leg, and then he delivers the line.
The name's Bond. James Bond.
And that is the first time he says this phrase in the entire film, and I just absolutely love the way it is delivered by Daniel Craig. And I really like Daniel Craig's performance in this one. Though, if you have watched my video where I ranked all of the actors who played Bond, I have put Daniel Craig in a fairly low position because of the subsequent films. I'll definitely talk about why in the upcoming reviews, but for this film in itself, I think Craig gives a really good performance, and the way he delivers that line in the end is actually very good. And this is also the first time in the entire 2 hours 20 minutes of the film where we get the classic Bond soundtrack. That is literally the first time you actually hear that soundtrack, which is very fascinating to me, because the entire film, they never use this classic tune, and in the end, they just pop it in at the right moment. Absolutely love the way it ends. Really love Casino Royale. I don't really have anything against it. I mean, the action's incredible, the way it opens, it's really different, and it has a story that seamlessly flows between different tones. It could have ended up being messy and just, you know, disjointed, but it never feels that way. It's extremely well paced, it is extremely rewatchable, it is extremely entertaining, and it is one of the best Bond films ever made. With all of that said, I'm going to give Casino Royale an A+. On the entertainment scale, it is a 9.5 out of 10. Absolutely love this film. It is one of the best ones. Those are my thoughts on Casino Royale. Comment down below what you guys think about this film. Do you love it? Is it one of your favorite Bond films? Is it not? What is your favorite Bond film of all time? Comment all of that down in the comments. If you enjoyed this video, do give it a like. Also, don't forget to subscribe so that you stay up to date with all of the videos on this channel. Also, stay tuned for my review of Quantum of Solace, which is going to come out very soon. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you again.